Hey, what is up, you guys? Reversal here, and welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Go. In this one, we got a lot of news. I actually recorded something yesterday as well, which are special 2Ks that I've been hatching. So we're gonna paste that after this video. There's some additional information on that as well. But as you guys can see over here, trainers, can you believe it? Pokemon Go's second anniversary is here. And there's a nice little Pikachu hat with sunglasses here in order to celebrate it. Let's bring up the article right here. Celebrate Pokemon Go's second anniversary with Pikachu. They're saying, can you believe it's the second anniversary of Pokemon Go? Thank you so much for adventuring with us and catching Pokemon all over the world. You truly are what makes this journey so special. None other than Pikachu has joined in to celebrate, well, you know, obviously Pikachu, to celebrate this momentous occasion, so keep an eye out for Pikachu and Pichu. Obviously, Pichu will be available through egg hatches more often. They have the potential to become a shiny, so that's pretty interesting, as it will appear more frequently tomorrow, July 6th, which actually is today. So officially, happy anniversary to Pokemon Go. Happy second anniversary to Pokemon Go. Tell me in the comments down below, what is your favorite memory of this game? What is the most memorable moment for you in Pokemon Go? To me, to be completely honest with you, when I take a look back at the game, the one thing that I really loved was the three-step tracker. And a lot of you don't know exactly what that was, but that was in the very beginning. Like the first, I would say 10 days or so, there was a tracker in Pokemon Go. And it had three footsteps if you were far away. And if you got closer, the amount of footsteps that were on the tracker would decrease to two and then one and then no steps at all. And that's how you knew that a Pokemon was right there. I personally think that that is the only sort of minor text fixes they should have never fixed. But that is my fondest memory, going after a Weezing, going after a Growlithe, and so on and so forth. Really exciting stuff. But this event is going to be happening starting today until July 31st, which is one of the longest events we've ever had in Pokemon Go. Pretty interesting. Plus this year, you can say hello throughout the month to a summer-style Pikachu that is decked out with a straw hat and sunglasses. And on top of that, there's going to be Pikachu fan item avatars available for everyone up there. If you have a golden Pikachu fan medal, it should be easy to obtain this month. You have the capability of purchasing all related items. I personally feel, and this is just personal opinion, that you should just like get them and then have a couple of items as well that you can just purchase, like without having any sort of requirement, because I know people are just gonna complain about that. But yeah, that aside, just also some amazing stories from trainers. And then we're also excited that special research on the mythical Pokemon Celebi will be available globally in the near future. So stay tuned. Finally, news of Celebi in Pokemon Go. We're gonna head over to the Twitter of Thrall's because he actually has like some of the assets that he's able to show. So this is the Summer Pikachu family. This is the Summer Pichu, Summer Pikachu, and Summer Raichu. They look really silly. Honestly, they look really silly. And I love it. This is actually one of those that I really like. And there are shiny variances of this as well. I mean, Sunburned Pikachu Mudge or Sunburned Raichu here. I mean, yeah, you cannot really notice the difference that much between shiny Pichu and just regular Pichu. Well, a little bit. It's a little bit like, I don't know. Don't know how to explain it. A little bit more colorful, I guess. But they're all colorful. A little bit darker. Like maybe a little tone, right? Like a tone darker, I guess. These are Pikachu fan mail avatar items. And the moment I saw these for female, I was literally thinking about Pokemon Master Holly. She must be going crazy right now to the fact that she's going to be able to wear the Pikachu. Yeah, there she is. To be able to wear the Pikachu avatars in game. I mean, they look really dope as well. You got the Pikachu hat. You got the Pikachu t-shirt, which by the way looks like a really cool shirt. If anybody can find a replica of this, like in real life, I'll definitely be down to buy it and wear it. Like, no questions asked. And these jeans or pants look really cool with like the keychain of a Pikachu and like a little Pokeball down there. And the Converse, of course, they need like special Pikachu Converse edition, which probably actually do exist. And then for the female, what is different is going to be the shirt. Obviously right here, and then yeah, the weird looking pants, just like that. I'm probably gonna get some Slack for say something like that. And over here, sunglasses items for trainers. Don't really know how to feel about them. They're cool, I guess. They could be a little bit... Like, they should have the Squirtle Squad glasses, if anything. Like, both variants. But maybe that will still be a thing. I don't know. Thank you, Thralls, for providing us with the information. Now, we got some more news before we dive into yesterday's video that I actually recorded, which will be pasted behind this video because it's actually pretty important. We got the Pokemon website. Now, some of you guys are saying, ooh, news coming from the Pokemon side is not real. No, this is as official as it can get. This is coming straight from the Pokemon Company. Pokemon Company works together with Niantic. If Niantic has an idea, they need to ask for permission to the Pokemon Company and be like, hey, we got an idea. Is this something that fits Pokemon? And if they give the go, then it's gonna be in the game. So this is as official as it can get, and I'm gonna link this in the description down below. Pokemon Go Turns 2. Okay, so there's a lot of information here, but this is the most important part. If you're running low on space to store all of these Pokemon you're catching and trading with friends, increased storage capacity is now available in-game in the in-game shop, allowing you to hold up to 2,000 Pokemon. Another Pokemon storage increase. It's very welcome. People are gonna be very happy with this one. And I don't think there's anything else with that. Just everything is just like, hey, they also announced this. I just checked the game a minute ago. It is not there yet, but pretty much can assume that it will be here later today. So that is the good news. Pokemon storage increase. I'm pretty sure you guys are really excited for that. At least, you know, those of you guys who wanted this. Because there's a lot of you out there. Anyway, there's another part to this video which I'm going to be talking about right now. As you guys already know, got back from the Dortmund Safari Zone. And then tonight, we should be having day 2. So if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you stay notified with everything that I'm doing in regards to Pokemon Go. But I got a couple of 2Ks that are hatching from this event. So without any further ado, let's see what we get from these eggs. It literally can be anything at this point. I didn't manage to hatch a whole lot of Pokemon here during the event on itself. But this one is a Larvitar, 488 CP. Certainly caught my attention. HP is the highest, matched equally by defense, and certainly impressed. As you guys can see, Dortmund, North, Rhin, West Philadelphia. I'm kidding. West Phalia. In Germany, so we're gonna save that one because it's a special Pokemon. Also, we just got some word. I actually let's see what this one is first. Taylor from a special 2K. Okay, so I actually tweeted at Niantic. I was like, you know, there was some words going around because obviously we unlocked everything from the global research challenge on the first one, which enabled Articuno Day, which is gonna be happening in 2 days from now, on the 7th of July. But I tweeted out because there were two tweets, or two replies from support in circulation. One stating that Regice and also Articuno will be spawning simultaneously. And then another one saying that only Articuno would be spawning. So I just figured, you know, Niantic, please clarify this. Got a reply back, and yes, it is only going to be Articuno that's going to be spawning during the event period of time. Figured I'd let you guys know. Gives me an excuse to put that in this video as well. Baltoy right here. This is a pretty rare hatch for me. I don't really hatch this one very often. I don't even know if this is in regular 2Ks or in 5Ks. Okay, let's take a look. It's a wonder. Defense stats exceeded. Could be anything. Could be 96. Could be 82. Really got no idea on Baltoy, to be honest. I actually did manage to hatch a Bagon and a Beldum really like in short period of time between each other, which was very exciting. We got a Tyrogue here. So 215 CP. I think that's pretty high actually. It's a wonder. HP, certainly impressed. Okay. So this one will actually evolve, I reckon, into Hitmontop here, which I'm just gonna do right now. Because HP, main stat. If it's defense, it evolves into Hitmonchan, like the appraisal. If that's HP, that will be Hitmontop. And then defense will be Hitmonchan. And then attack would be Hitmonlee. Now, if the stats are like HP, attack, and defense, if that shows up in the appraisal right here, then it literally could be any of these Pokemon. So make sure you keep note of that. So Hitmontop, not too bad. Not too bad here. I'm not really sure how many more eggs I have. Maybe one or two. Shellder, I wanted the orange one. I wanted the shiny one on this one. I want a shiny Shellder so bad, man. Today's video on the Safari Zone is going to be really insane. I'm going to get myself some shinies I really wanted for a while now. So, really excited for that one. So, make sure you stay tuned for that. So, this one was a pretty decent Shellder. Not that I'm going to do anything with it, but that's okay. Ooh, Swablu. Nice, okay, getting myself some candy here, bringing me over 400, which is good. You know, I'm attempting to, with any special evolution, like let's say a Magikarp, a Swablu, or even Wailmer, I want to be having at least 400 candy, because we don't know when the next special research will be released, but one of the quests might just be evolve one of these three Pokemon into the next form, and then if you have already done the evolve, it might take you some time in order to actually obtain these Pokemon. So this Swablu is not really that great. Is this the final one? No, we got one more. Okay, pleasant surprise here. I'm actually happy with that. Let's see what it is. Ooh, Machop. I actually don't really care too much because I got 6 Machamps actually maxed out of Machop here. But I do, this is like 15 attack right here, that's pretty solid. Brick Break, Rock Smash. Yeah, there's that. Okay, awesome. So let's go ahead and take a look at my eggs right now. So as you guys can see, got 2 in incubating. I actually got an Alolan egg. I was opening up some gifts, and that's where I found out that I got myself an Alolan egg. I'm not really too keen on Alolan eggs at this point anymore. I pretty much got everything. Let's go ahead and go to the Alolan Pokemon right here to kind of give you like a little look-see. So, Rattata, Sandshrew, Meowth, all the evolved forms, Grimer, and of course, I got my Ninetales, which was the featured Pokemon. So, yeah, after that, Alolan Pokemon are just kind of like, they're rather, I guess, a little bit lackluster. I mean, I'm going to incubate this and all, and I will hatch it, but I don't know. I'm actually gonna try to, you know, get some regular egg hatches, because as much fun as Alolan eggs are, I've hatched so many already so quickly that they aren't really a whole lot interesting to me, unless I got my, oh, Pope Dave. That actually brings me to my next point. That wasn't actually something I was gonna mention in any way, shape, or form, but I do wanna give Pope Dave some love here. So, very recently, Pope Dave was streaming Pokemon Go on Twitch. He's one of the very few people who still streams Pokemon Go on Twitch. As a matter of fact, he's the biggest guy on Twitch for Pokemon Go. So, he's considered a Pokemon Go influencer, if you will. And very recently, he was streaming Pokemon Go. And I'm just gonna leave some links in the description down below, so that way you guys can read on it for yourself. But long story short, he got in a pretty nasty accident in which he broke both of his heels, and he is stuck in a cast and in a wheelchair for the next like 2 to 3 months. He's actually going to be attending Pokemon Go Fest, so I'm really excited for that, but his medical bills have been extremely high, so this is kind of like a plea from me to you. If you can find it in your heart to support my boy Pope Dave, then I'll leave some links to that in the description down below to his GoFundMe. It has it perfectly described, the amount of funds, like America's healthcare system just completely sucks, or just medical system. Everything is so gosh darn expensive. And yeah, I just don't, you know, I just wanted to give my buddy, my homie, some love here. So definitely support him if you can. And that's basically all there is to that. And of course, I figured I should give you guys a little bit of an update on how I'm doing with everything. And as you guys can see, only 10,000 experience to go, and then I need 500,000, and I'm at 100 million experience. I've been holding off quite a bit, and during this community day, it's gonna be pretty tough, but I'll just shiny check everything and not catch a single Pokemon, and of course do the research quest in which you have the capability of getting the Squirtle Squad glasses thing. And then I also suspect that the drop rate of shinies during the Articuno day, it's gonna be pretty high, highly obtainable, I reckon, because you only have 3 hours to get yourself that. So we're organizing in my community some Articuno raid trades left, right, and center, and of course your boy is gonna be participating in that as well. I'm gonna have to get that Articuno soon, because otherwise I'll be getting too much experience and I might go over 100 million. I'm gonna try to get it on the dot, but I don't know about you guys, like, it's gonna be a tough one in my personal opinion. We still got a week away until Pokemon Go Fest is here, a week and a little, 9 days until Pokemon Go Fest is gonna be starting, and that's finally going to be the time in which I'm gonna be obtaining the 100 million mark in Pokemon Go. I'm so excited for that. Also, let me know in the comment section down below, how are you guys planning your Articuno day? Are you guys excited for Community Day as well? But yeah, that's it for me for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned. Pokemon Go Safari Zone day number 2 is going to be released later today. And then Pokemon Go Fest, my 2017 adventure, will be released after that. Like tomorrow or something like that. Because yes, it still needs to be released. Anyway, that being said, this has been Reverse for Pokemon Go. I'm going to be signing off and I'll see you guys in the next one.